Today I'm going to make momos, and these are chicken momos that I'll be making, and they're very easy to make, tasty, healthy, low calorie options that can be used for any snack, tiffin items, giving it to school children, and they're really, really easy to make, and you do not need much of the ingredients. Please keep watching and I'll tell you how to make these delicious momos at home. The ingredients for the momo are as following. These are boneless pieces of chicken, so you can see that they are cut into small pieces. Then we have green chilies finely chopped. We have red onions also very finely chopped. Then there is ginger extremely finely chopped. And sorry, this is ginger finely chopped. This is garlic finely chopped. So we have both ginger and garlic finely chopped. We have spring onions, which is a rather an optional ingredient, but if you can give it, it improves the taste. So we have also spring onions finely chopped, and I have taken 2 teaspoons of oil, black pepper powder and salt, and last but not the least, we have flour, which is the ingredient that goes into making the coating for the momo. Next, we are going to put everything in a blender. So I have taken the blender and I'm going to put almost everything in it. So first goes in the onions, then I shall put in the ginger. This will be followed by the garlic that goes in. Now the green chilies is as per your taste, so give whatever you feel will be right. And then in goes the chicken. So but before that, I will be just taking out a few, because I think it's quite more than that I need. So here, yes, now with everything inside, I shall put a bit of the pepper. Yes, that's all right. And we put a bit of the salt. So now the salt and pepper is as per your the way you want to measure it up, in keeping in proportion with the chicken that goes in to making the paste. This will be, in fact, once they are blended together, they will all become very nice and soft, and they can become the filling of the momo. So we are going to put everything now and blend it. While we have put the chicken in the blender and it's getting blended. So in this particular flour, I'm going to put in salt and a little bit of the oil, so that the dough can be quite smooth. And we are going to mix it up now, and we are going to make a dough out of it. So we are going to mix it very finely, and I'll put water, and we will have a dough made out of this flour. You can see that the dough has been finely made, kneaded into a very soft texture. Now we are going to take out one particular portion of it, make it into small balls, and we are going to flatten them out. So this is one ball, and now we are going to flatten these balls out and make them, roll them and make them into small puri like structures. So that would be the outer covering. So I'm going to now roll them and make them into, roll out and make them into small puris. Here I have made 2 puris to show you, and here are the balls, the flattened out balls. And now we are going to go back and see what happened to the blended chicken. So here is the blended chicken. If you look very carefully, you see this is a very fine mix, mince like paste that we have, and all the onion, the garlic and the ginger and the green chilies have been mixed very well, along with the salt and the pepper. Now we can add spring onions as per our taste, as much as you would like to go into it and put into it, and then that is completely according to your taste. What we shall do now is that you, after mixing it up, we are going to make little balls out of them. So we are going to divide this into small balls. So I take a bit in my hand and I roll it and I make it into a small ball. So, and I'm going to put it aside in a plate. You can see there are other small balls that I've made. This is going to be the filling that is going to your momo. Now I will take each puri And as I take a puri, I am going to take one of those chicken balls that we made out of the mince. And now it is the time to roll these up. Now, rolling of a momo is very easy. What we have to do is that we have to remember how we pleat. If you know how to pleat a sari, or if you know how to pleat any garment, that is exactly the method that we shall follow. And this is the way that we pleat, and we close up, and there is your momo done. So this is the way the momos will be made. Now all the stuffing, chicken stuffing, has been put inside the puris, and they have been turned into momos. As you can see, that each one of them has been given the twist and the pleat, and they have been turned into a momo. Now I'm going to put them for steaming. For steaming, there is one usually uses a steamer, but if you don't have a steamer at home, not to worry, and I'll tell you how we can innovatively steam a momo and yet get delicious ones on your plate. So here, what do I have? I have a pan of a certain height, which in vernacular it's called degchi in Bengali. I think the same is called a handi in Hindi. And I have filled it up with water, and on that top of that I've put a strainer. A strainer plate is one that we commonly use for straining rice. So you can put it on top here, and I will be lightly brushing it with oil. So I'll take a bit of oil in my hand and I will lightly brush it. Now it's very important that you do not pour the oil, but you take it in your hand and you brush it, or if you have a brush you can use that also. This is very important so that when you're putting the momos in it, the momos do not stick to this strainer. So I have coated this, and you can see that it's now looks quite lubricated. So here I'm going to put all the momos, and I have turned on the gas and it's on high flame. So here I'm going to put in all the momos, and after putting in all the momos, I'm going to cover and cook it. And let me tell you, it doesn't take much time, about 20 to 25 minutes. You can open the cover from time to time and check. You will see there will be a slight change in the texture of the flour, and there will be a change in the way the momo looks from now and then. And you will know. In fact, you can take one out, cut one for experimental sake, and decide whether it has been cooked or not. You see, once a chicken is in a minced condition, it does not take much time to cook. Hence, now you can see I've put all the momos into the strainer. What am I going to do next is that I'm going to cover it up with another plate on top. And this is how it is covered. It is completely sealed. There is no air which will go into it. And I will let it cook for the next 20 minutes. Now you can see that there is a lot of steam coming out from this covered portion. And I am going to open it and see if the momos have been done. This 20 minutes that has lapsed. And yes, can you see them glistening? Can you see that they do not look raw anymore? The dough looks cooked. This is the time that tells you that the momo is cooked and we can plate it. So I'll cover it and I'm going to plate these momos. Now I've put the momos on the plate, and as you can see that I have got little sauce here. This is a momo sauce, and one of these days on my channel I'll tell you how to make a momo sauce. It's simple. You can just use a tomato puree base and put in some red chili powder and stir it up over fire, and that's your momo sauce. You can use little bit of spring onion in it also. So now that the momos are on the plate and it looks shiny and glistening, it's ready to eat. So shall we test whether it has been cooked or not? Let's cut one momo with a knife and see how it looks on the inside. You see, the chicken has turned fully white and it has been fully cooked. So there is no way we can say that it is raw. So all these momos have been cooked and it's ready to eat. So what are you waiting for? Go try some of these recipes and hope and tell me how do you like my channel, my recipes. And you must have noted that the momos have been cooked with very little oil, although I had taken 2 teaspoons. But at the end, I saw that I had only used 1 teaspoon. So this is again another good option that you can use with low calorie food option that can be used to give tiffin to your children when they are going to school, and it is an interesting tiffin. They all like to eat it and will be happy serving it. They'll be happy eating it, and go and enjoy it. Share, subscribe and like my videos, and thank you for watching.